It's a long way to Nashville.
I just want to say how much I love singing with this guy right here.
Here's hoping that she knows me when I stand outside her door.
He's a great guitar player. He's a wonderful songwriter.
Why don't you come and get me?
And she is just one of my favorite singers of all time. This is Nell Robinson.
I don't think I can stand to see you.
What kind of music do we play?
Country music.
My gray skies are gone.
Folk.
Bluegrass.
Come and listen in to our podcast station. We're the mighty hosts of the heavens.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your Android
Turn
on.
Turn your iPhone on.
Americana.
Celtic.
Blues.
Swing.
Now. I'm the
and I get to play with these guys.
Coming to you from Music Gone Public, curated concerts for public television.
It's way too complicated to say. I feel like honey, I feel like dirt. I love you, I hate you, I'm afraid. Oh honey, I'm lonesome tonight, but I want you to leave me alone. Still I'd rather have your warm embrace than the cold comfort of the phone. Well, my heart says one thing, my head says another, my words come out wrong too. Why are things so complicated when it comes to you?
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It is such an honor to be here and a pleasure to be here. Caleb Marr lived alone in them hollering pines, and he made a little whiskey for himself, set it up to pass the time. Long one evening in back of my house, Caleb come around, and he called my name till I went out, no one else around. But when I go to sleep at night, don't you call my name. Where's your husband, Nellie King? Where's your darling gone? Did he go on down the mountainside, leave you all alone? Yes, my husband's gone to Bowling Green to do some business there. Then Caleb threw that bottle down, grabbed me by my hair.
Nothing else matters.
my arms, right where you belong. The love that we knew is living again, and nothing
you just love it. Buck Owens and Don Rich. Oh, amazing. We love that music. We were talking a little bit about daughters backstage and children, and I have an only child. She's now 24, but it seems like just yesterday that she was two. And we went through a lot of very tricky times. She was a very independent girl, and she was very independent starting very young. And so we were kind of like, you know, at it for years. And really, and I was just thinking, I know I didn't raise you to be like that. You know, I raised you better than that. But she, as everyone promised, she has come back to me. She went to college as far away as she could go and still speak English, went to Edinburgh. And she's come back. She graduated from college, and she's living in Berkeley. She's got a job, yeah. And we're just like this. We're so close. And so when I look at her now, I experience this when I look at her, and sometimes I have the same experience when I look at myself in the mirror. Oh, it's going to choke me up. I see her beautiful 24-year-old face, but I also see 16. And I see 11, and I see 2, all in that same beautiful face. And so we're going to do a song that I wrote for her with Jim's help, and it's called Mirror.
Did she become defiant when you said you were going to dye your hair blue?
I think she was born defiant, actually. Which I love. Powerful young woman. It's awesome.
You know, if
right?
all you...
It's great. It's a powerful young woman. It's fantastic.
If you hear me say something, just laugh, even if it's not funny.
Yeah. So whenever Jim opens his mouth, that's your cue.
Me away. Full-blown rebellion has battle fought and won. Farewell, milky days when you and I were one. Tender kisses for my girl as she walks into the sun.
Going to play a song now. This is one that I started to write when I was traveling way up in the frozen north up in Canada, and was driving across the tundra up there and frozen icy ground, and it made me just shiver, and I wanted to be back in California near a beach with a warm wind blowing over me. So that inspired me to write a verse and a chorus to this tune called South Wind. And then I kind of ran out of steam. And so I passed it over to Nell, and she finished it out.
That's right. I took it further south. I took it to L.A., which is Lower Alabama to you Yankees. My family's from L.A., Lower Alabama. And we spent our summers on the Gulf there with that soft, sugary sand and those long sandbars and the warm water. And that's a place I long for when I'm cold. So we've got a little of both. Here it is. I hear a south wind.
One, two, three,
four, one, two, three. I hear a south wind call my name, beckoning me back to the sunny days, where the warm wind blows on my chilly bones. I hear a south wind call my name. Winter here has been so cold, the nights are long, the days so short. How I long to feel that soft cold breeze with warm sand beneath my feet. I hear a south wind call my name, beckoning me back to the sunny days, where the warm wind blows on my chilly bones. I hear a south wind call my name.
The soul falls fast through like the north winds blow. Give me the sultry days and song Thursday,
someone I know. I hear a south wind call my name, beckoning me back to the sunny days, where the warm wind blows on my chilly bones. I hear a south wind call my name, where the warm wind blows on my chilly bones. I hear a south wind call my name.
So much.
Okay, see, they're not on this next song, so they got to check their email and text and whatever.
Well, this is actually, you know what we try? This is actually a public service. We actually have, during the show, you have a little break, so folks who are having smartphone separation anxiety,
you can
check your
it's
text,
okay.
Or you can actually, you know, do a selfie or...
Yeah. Oh, cat video. Okay,
all right. Very good. Thanks for sharing, Pete.
Thanks for sharing.
Come and listen in to our podcast station. We're the mighty hosts of the heavens.
Ping. Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your Android
Turn
on.
Turn your iPhone on.
If you want to hear your songs without buying, coming from the web of endless streams,
trust in the cloud.
Trust in the cloud.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Download your music through the air.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Press a button to share.
Turn your ringer down low.
Turn your ringer down low.
So others can enjoy the show.
Get in touch with Jobs.
Get in touch with Jobs.
Turn your smartphone on. Big Brother keeps a record of all your texting. Apple knows where you have been.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your Android on.
Turn your iPhone on.
How can I feel oh so lonely when I have a million Facebook friends?
Trust in the cloud.
Trust in the cloud.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
You can do it all with an app.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
It'll even wipe your nose.
Use your airplane mode.
Use your airplane mode.
Because your batteries are running low.
Get in touch with Jobs.
Get in touch with Jobs.
Turn your smartphone on. All the songs of your fathers and mothers. YouTube is the new TV.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your Android
Turn
on.
Your iPhone on.
I can't wait to get another link to cute kitties and campaign stupidity.
Trust in the cloud.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Is that a phone or a toy?
Turn your smartphone on.
Turn your smartphone on.
Don't tell me that's a BlackBerry.
Oops, the secret is leaked. You can buy your iPhone 7 next week.
If you trust the cloud.
If you trust the cloud.
Turn your smartphone on. But you can't trust the cloud. So turn your smartphone off.
Okay, but before you turn off your smartphone, like us on Facebook. We're so happy to welcome Jim Kerwin out here on the bass fiddle. Yeah.
Thank you.
awaken from my winter's dream. I believe I'm in midair. The tallest pines are rocking neath me. Every blade of grass swollen by storms. And you
another tune here. This is one that was done by a great brother duet called Jim and Jesse McReynolds. And what I think is very cool about this song is that it features in country music the country music rumba boogie. That's the rumba beat that was kind of introduced by the late great Hank Snow. And we're going to have John kick it off in that rumba style, the old rumba style. You guys are ready? All right, John, take her away.
sit there and find right or wrong.
Do you folks like George Jones? How about Melba Montgomery? Well, George and Melba, I think they were married, but in any case, they had a wonderful bluegrass album, and this is one of the tunes off of that record, and I really enjoy that album a lot. And I don't know if it ever came out on CD, but certainly out on LP. For those of you who remember LP.
I hear they're making a comeback, but I don't believe it.
It's called Jump the Mississippi.
One, two, three.
I've been lonely much too long. I give you a dime if you come back. Honey, won't you let me hold you tight? Tears keep a falling and my eyes are blurred. If I had the wings of a pretty little bird, I would fly right to your arms tonight. Well, I'd jump the Mississippi deep and wide. If you was waiting on the other side, honey, just to hug and hold you tight. I'd jump across and never get wet. Right there by your side I'd say, yes, indeedy, everything's gonna be all right. Start out and meet you halfway. I'd leave here and never look back. I'd run a mile in a minute flat to get to you before the end of day. Well, I'd jump the Mississippi deep and wide if you was waiting on the other side, honey, just to hug and hold you tight. I'd jump across and never get wet. Right there by your side I'd say, yes, indeedy, everything's gonna be all right.
All right. Here's one called Homes Where I Long to Be.
Lonely roads I've traveled, far away, and leave me with a feeling like I have today. Longing to be back in a place that I know well. Home's where I think about the story that I love to hear. Memories of the old times we would share. Yearning to be back in a place that I know well. Home's where I long to be. Thank you.
to my friends and folks back home. When I return with stories to tell, you're the reason to be back in a place that I know well. Home's where I long to be. That's where I long to be. Home where I long to be.
Thank you.
It's my pleasure to introduce this fella here to my left. He learned to play guitar and sing from his dad, and at a very young age. And I love it because he continues that tradition. So he has mentored and taught hundreds and hundreds of guitar players, singers, and songwriters through bluegrass camps and music camps and through lessons and those things. And that's folk music, right? I mean, that's what it's all about. We just keep passing it on. He is a key member of the David Grisman Bluegrass Experience. He's been in that band for 14 years. I don't think David takes a bluegrass gig if Jim can't join in. And if you've seen that band, you've heard him sing. He does most of the singing. He's just good at everything he does. This is Jim Nunnally.
Thank you so very much. Thank you, Nell.
Welcome.
Well, it's time for a Tammy Wynette song.
This is another song inspired by a book. I'm a voracious reader, and this is based on a imagery from a book by Paul Yoon, and it's called Snow Hunters, and the name of the song is Tree.
So much. I want to tell you about Nell. Now, she actually started singing music only about 7 years ago in public, and she started a program down in Berkeley called Take the Stage, which was held at the Freight and Salvage Coffee House, and that's actually when we met. Actually, she set up a program for folks who actually wanted to perform, who'd never had the opportunity, but they played music. So
closet musicians.
Closet musicians who were coming out. So she actually set that up for them, and they got to take this course, basically, where they would study with people that played music professionally, and I happened to be one of the folks that she hired to coach. And many other folks, that's when we met, and so she started performing, decided that she wanted to make a record. She made a record, and her first record was called Luango. Her second record was called On the Brooklyn Road. And her third record was the one that we did as a duo. It's called House and Garden, because I enjoyed her singing so much in the studio. I said, man, I really want to do some duo work with her. And her latest record is called Rose of No Man's Land. She has played, and I think this is quite amazing, on A Prairie Home Companion. Yes.
Yay.
And it was really, really quite interesting, because what she was doing, she was with a woman named Carrie Sheldon, and they had a duet called the Cackle Sisters. And Now, what I'm about to tell you is the truth. It was yodeling like chickens really fast and making barnyard sounds. Garrison Keillor heard that and called them up and said, you need to be on this show.
You know how he loves chickens.
So she's performed at the Kennedy Center as well, and she is just one of my favorite singers of all time. This is Nell Robinson.
Look who I found backstage. Come on up, Bob Littell. Give him a huge hand, y'all.
Hello, Chico.
We're so pleased he's going to join us and add a little sauce to some Hank Williams. How about that?
Sauce, yes. Sauce is my middle name.
Yeah.
Hey, Pete. You feeling blue over there, buddy?
Oh, man. Blue.
Why don't you give us some of the blues right there?
Got them long gone.
blues away.